Nestled in the reserve forests of Guindy in Chennai is an almost five-decade-old snake park. For years together, the Chennai Snake Park has attracted millions of visitors. But with the pandemic, the park has been closed for 11 months now. Its staff are struggling to feed 300 odd reptiles, including 20 baby gharials that are new additions to the park. They were only born last year, but with no visitors, the park staff are now requesting for funds to feed these babies. In 2020, when the park was fully shut down to visitors, its Gangetic gharials bred for the first time in the history of the park. Now, the Chennai Snake Park has 20 Gangetic gharial babies and 5 Indian python juveniles. But the park authorities are struggling to maintain them. They've requested for public donations and they've written to the Tamil Nadu Chief Minister asking for funds.
In all these years, we have not had an incidence of gharial birth in our zoo. So it might be likely that the low visitation or lack of visitors and the ensuing silence might have facilitated the reproduction of the gharials. It's one thing that we are still studying.
A Schedule 1 protected species under the Indian Wildlife Act, the Gangetic gharials are an extremely threatened species. Its adults and babies are fed a variety of fish by the park staff. Along with the gharials, the park also saw the birth of 5 python babies in 2020. The snake park also houses iguanas, venomous and non-venomous snakes such as cobras and crates, and turtles, tortoises and crocodiles. The iguanas are fed fruit and vegetables including beetroot, cabbage, papaya and radish. The crocodiles are given meat including beef and lamb cuts, which are fit for human consumption. Water snakes and gharials feed on fish bought from the market, while certain other snakes are fed mice and rats procured from labs.
Most of the expenses of our park goes in on animal feeding and upkeep. Right? It takes competent and trained personnel for executing the work of animal upkeep and maintenance. And sadly, these days we need to cut down on their salary as well as the staff strength to keep the park going. That is to ensure that the maintenance goes on as normal as it is.
I'm standing in front of the python enclosure, and similar to this, there are 25 different species of snakes that this park houses. Apart from this, there are 10 other species of crocodiles, turtles, tortoises and other reptiles. All of these are being maintained by less than 10 staff members, and the park desperately needs funds either from the state or from the public by way of donations in order to bring back their original staff strength. 90% of the park staff were handpicked from the Irula tribal community.
So these are a group of people who are well versed with reptiles and generally about wildlife. They were hunter-gatherer community in the past, but over the years they are now weaned of their traditional occupation and they have moved on to choosing to other kinds of jobs. But we wanted to cash in on their traditional instincts and knowledge about the reptiles in general.
Before the pandemic, the park survived on visitors' fee, making up to rupees 6 or 7 lakh a month. But with no announcement on when it can be opened once again, authorities are not sure how long the park can survive without funds. Even if it opens soon, the staff are only expecting minimal footfall. If you do want to contribute toward the upkeep of the Chennai Snake Park, here are the bank account details and the UPI details to make payments to. Reporting from Chennai, this is Sridevi Jayarajan for the News Minute.